Now, the next question over here says, a sum of rupees 700 is to be used to give 7 cash prizes. So the number of cash prizes are 7 and the total amount is 700 to students of a school for their overall academic performance. If each prize is 20 less than its preceding prize, then find the value of each prizes. Now it is given that each prize is 20 less than its preceding prize. Correct? Now if we assume over here, now I'll tell you, there is, first of all, you need to understand what the question has to say. Over here, what it has to say is that if we let the maximum prize be A, the next prize is A minus 20, the next prize is A minus 40, the next prize is A minus 60, next prize is A minus 80, and so on. 7 prizes are there and we need to calculate each and every prize. Now I'll tell you, if we write this question the other way around, if we let the least cash prize be A. Okay, now we've let the least cash prize be A. So the first term is going to be A over here, correct? Plus the next cash prize would be 20 more than A, correct? Now this is just a way I am trying to explain the question to you. This is the first, that is A. The second is A plus 20. The third is A plus 40. The fourth is A plus 60. The fifth is A plus 80. The sixth is A plus 100. And the seventh is A plus 120. Correct? Now this whole is going to be equal to 700. Am I correct? This whole is going to be equal to 700. Now, one thing you can do is, the solution to this question can be, find out the value of A from here. Very easy. How? We know there are 7 A's. So, 7 A plus 20 plus 40, 60 plus 60, 120 plus 80, 200 plus 100, 300 plus 120. This is equal to 420 is equal to 700. 7A is equal to 700 minus 420 is 280, and A from here is equal to 280 by 7, that is equal to 40. So if A here is equal to 40, so the cash prizes would be as follows: 40, 60, 80, after 80 there would be 100, then 120, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 140 and 160. Now these cash prizes are given, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is it. This is the solution to the question if you understand and go with this method. Now if we are very desperate to use the sum of, the formula for the sum of AP. So the formula says, S is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Correct? Am I right? Now it is very simple. We know the sum, that is equal to 700. We know what is n. N is equal to 7. So this is 7 by 2. We don't know the value of a, right? 2a plus, we know, and we know the value of n, that is again 7, so n minus 1 is equal to 6, and we know the value of d, that is equal to 20. Correct? Now again, a here is not the maximum but the least prize awarded. A is the least prize awarded. Correct? Now from here, you can find out the value of A. It is again going to be very easy. This 700 into 2, I have taken this 2 over here, is equal to, and I can also divide this by 7, right? I have divided this by 7 and multiplied this by 2. So next, what remains in this is 2A plus 120, and this over here becomes 200 minus 120 is equal to 2A. correct? And we have 80 is equal to 2a, or a here is equal to 80 by 2, that is equal to 40. Now again, if a is, we know that a is equal to 40. So if a is equal to 40, this is the first and the least cash price, correct? So the next is going to be again 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, and 160. Correct? Now, I've told you two ways to solve these questions. One is using the formula, one is without using the formula, just based on logic. So again, I'm telling you, to solve these statement questions, first of all, what do you need to do? You need to understand the logic behind them. Do not start with the formula. Do not do that. Start with the understanding of the logic. Try to understand what is given in the question. Try to deduce it for yourself. It will be very easy for you to solve these questions in the examinations.